Tuberculosis is an infectious disease caused by a bacteria called mycobacterium tuberculosis. And while it can affect any part of your body, it primarily affects the lungs, causing a condition called as pulmonary tuberculosis. India has a massive burden of this disease. About a quarter of all deaths that happen in the world due to tuberculosis happen in India. So one of the most important things in tackling tuberculosis is how do you find out whether a person has tuberculosis or not, or what we call as diagnosis. Typically, the way a diagnosis is done is that you take a fluid obtained from a patient's lung called the sputum, and you can culture the sputum. Although culture is the gold standard for detection of tuberculosis, it takes of the order of weeks to get a result, so it's not the most desirable method for diagnosis. So in 2010, a very interesting development happened where a certain machine called the Gene Expert was endorsed by the World Health Organization. Now this is a DNA-based test for tuberculosis, where you can take DNA from a mycobacterium, and you can amplify it. So think of it as copying a few copies of TB DNA and making something like 10 to the 10 copies of it. And once you make so many copies, you're able to now determine whether that person has tuberculosis or not, because you can detect that amplifying DNA. GeneXpert uses a technique called PCR, in which you have to do thermal cycling, where you heat the sample to 95 and back to a lower temperature. You have to cycle between several times, and that requires an expensive instrument. And this is the gold standard for doing DNA detection, but it's quite expensive, and that has really prevented tuberculosis diagnosis penetrating into deep parts of India. An alternative to PCR is what are called as isothermal DNA amplification techniques, which, as the name says, can amplify DNA at a constant temperature. And about 3 years ago, when I joined IISc, I had some experience with coupling isothermal amplification methods with paper-based microfluidics. And I thought that that technique could have a lot of application for TB diagnosis in India. And so I asked my first PhD student Abjur to look at it.
LAMP is a very difficult technique to work with, and it took us almost a year to completely understand the technique and generate reproducible results day in and day out. Once we understood the technique, the next job was to port all this technology for TB diagnostics into a paper-based portable device that will be compatible with point-of-care diagnostics. Bhushan had used these hybridization chambers in the past, and when we looked them up, they turned out to be exorbitantly expensive. That's when we thought, why don't we build our own enclosures? And that was the point of conception of FlipNAT, fluorescent isothermal paper and plastic nucleic acid amplification test, which is a DNA-based TB diagnostic. FlipNAT is a paper and plastic-based device where all the reagents required for testing are dry stored in these pieces of paper. The simple user experience involves peeling the flap off, adding the sample from these sample addition ports at the top, sealing the device and keeping it inside an incubator for the required amount of reaction time at a particular temperature. The device has to be then taken out, the peel removed again, and add the detection dye from the same sample ports and image it from the backside using the regular cell phone camera. This is all the user has to do to test for TB in FlipNAT. We recently tested 30 clinical patient samples in FlipNAT and found the results to be very promising. You can go out and look at our results in our published manuscript.
So the initial results of FlipNAT are really promising, but there are still three challenges, primary challenges we're trying to address. One is that we're trying to improve the shelf life of the reagents that are stored in these little paper discs. We are also trying to improve the specificity, that is, reduce the number of false positive TB test results that this device generated. And also sample preparation, which is the ability to remove DNA from this complex sputum sample, is currently not incorporated in the FlipNAT. So those are the three directions in which we are working. But the problem that FlipNAT is aiming to solve is delivery of diagnostics. So just like the pharma industry has been able to accomplish large-scale delivery of drugs using blister packs, we think that the FlipNAT can be used to deliver diagnostics in a blister pack kind of a device. And that's a really promising and new idea in this area. It has attracted a lot of attention. We've been contacted by several people asking us to collaborate with them to do larger scale studies. And we're really excited about the future of this device.